Ashley, you know, your father always fought against the Congress for much of his life. He was seen as an anti-Congress leader. You have joined the Congress. Immediately the Congress gives you a ticket. Why join the Congress, which many believe is a party in decline in Bihar?
Mr. Sardesai, as I mentioned before, my father is part of Mahagathbandhan since 2017. And with Congress party, he held so many campaign against the current government by the name of Saja Virasat Bachao. And being Congress, the national party, and Congress supporting this movement, and this opportunity again was given to me by Congress party. My father was ill. I had no plans to contest elections. But Mr. Ahmed Patel encouraged me to take forward his work and give, and this is actually giving a platform to Congress party as well, as you mentioned, that yes, of course, in Bihar, it doesn't have that cadre-based politics and party people. But yet I am trying to give Congress party also an identity.
You know, I want to ask both of you this in conclusion. What are the dreams and ideals of the younger generation, the Gen Next politicians? How are they different from the previous generation, Love Sinha? You know, the general perception is Bihar politicians fight on caste. Will this generation next talk about issues like employment, talk about issues like education? That's what the people want you to talk about. Do you believe that the younger generation leaders are more willing to talk about these issues than the previous generation?
So if you've seen any of my other interviews, basically I've been talking about primarily what the issues are that the public faces. Caste is not something you can avoid, but that's not something that should be the priority either. I know my caste. I know that I'm a Kayas. I'm very proud of it. But at the same time, I'm here to go along with everyone. I'm here to try and move forward with everyone if I'm given the opportunity to. Because leaving people behind, I don't think that's the right way. Because to take a nation forward, you need to move ahead with everyone. That's what I believe.
Interesting the way you're putting it. Subhashni, one final question. You know, we are seeing a lot of young women contesting this election. Young women politicians, many of them are daughters of politicians. But how difficult or easy is it to be a woman politician in a state like Bihar, very male-dominated politics?
Firstly, it's very encouraging. I am very happy to see so much women candidature across the state. And second, the acceptance. Women here in Bihar, what I've seen so far, is so much respected. And people here have faith on women. And they are giving so much love and support to me. I don't feel there is any gender inequality in this.
A final question, Love Sinha. Assume that you lose the election. Will you stay on in Bihar? Are you here for the long run? Or is this a flirtation?
So, I'll remind you, Rajdeep, you had interviewed me 10 years ago when my first film had released. I never left the industry. So I don't leave no matter where I start. Whatever the outcome may be, I'm here to stay and I'm here to fight even in the future.